Hi, I'm Audrey.
Hey, I'm Matt.
Welcome to Next Big Thing, and today we'll be talking about Matt's IoT project that controls the locks at your house. So you learned to code at Next, and I heard that you were involved in a very interesting IoT project. So maybe you could tell us a little bit about it.
So during the bootcamp, we work on an Airbnb project. From that, we kind of sprung off in the group project to use an IoT that would maybe sort of solve an issue that comes from the Airbnb, which is, if you imagine maybe an Airbnb host has 20 to 30 properties.
Yep.
How can they open the door for each one of those properties if they have everyone coming in at one time? So from that, what we did was we had a location-based locking system using an IoT device, and the device that we used was actually the Raspberry Pi. And then we used a Rails app that would actually send commands to the Raspberry Pi device to unlock and lock the door.
I love the idea because sometimes you just don't want to be there, right? Imagine it's like the person is coming in at 11 p.m. and I can't really, you know, go all the way out there to actually welcome my guests, for example, to the house. Mm-hmm. So it's really convenient to just have to lock and just unlock it from afar. Okay, so let's just rewind a little bit. Have you actually coded before you come?
No, before the bootcamp, I'd done zero coding. I just did some of the online work before I came in, but I didn't actually touch on any Python. So coming into the group project, I had zero experience with Python. So working on an IoT was something completely new for me.
What I would like to know is this, like during the bootcamp, we obviously didn't teach you about IoT, but would really, really want to know, how do you actually do it? Like, how do you get started into it? It's something completely new after all.
Especially for the Raspberry Pi, there is a huge community.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of documentation online and a lot of other projects that people have already attempted to do. So it's really nice because the hard work is done for you. Mm-hmm. As long as you have the time to read and understand what's going on with everything, it's quite easy to pick up how to write the scripts and how to actually make use of the GPIO pins on the Raspberry Pi device. The only thing that I really had the biggest trouble with was connecting the Raspberry Pi with our web app that was hosted on Heroku, because that was something that there's not a huge amount of documentation online about. And the biggest challenge for me with that was that you are using a Ruby Rails based web app to actually send commands to a Raspberry Pi, which primarily uses Python.
That's two very different technology stacks there. I often find that, you know, building hardware is really out of reach for me. You know, I've seen people doing like DIY stuff and whatnot, but very often I don't see that there is enough resources out there for me to actually just, you know, just stick and go and try it out. And I think the best that I've done so far is connecting lights and just putting the battery in it and it gets lit up. So how do you feel being able to create, you know, something like this and also being able to control it with software? So, I mean, you have the best of both worlds, hardware and software. How do you feel when you actually are able to build it?
Yeah, I mean, I'm a creative person, so I like to build things with my hands. But obviously, before this, I would have never been able to actually program something and have it work the way I want it to work, rather than take something that someone's already built for you, kind of put it together and then it just works. So now I can customize it to work the way I want it to. And also for me as well, it was a great learning experience. And it kind of gives you a better understanding of how some of the technology that we use nowadays, the amount of work that goes into making these things work.
I know, right? Yeah. So what are some of the other projects that you're thinking about? Do you have anything in mind?
I do have one project on mind at the minute. I'd obviously like to play around with machine learning a little bit. So in the near future, I'm hoping to play around with a Raspberry Pi again and hopefully build a self-driving remote control car.
That's nice. Are you guys going to race?
Possibly.
So what drives you to learn to code?
Yeah, I understand the future is going to be very technology driven. So coming out of automotive and wanting to have a career change, I want to be able to work with technology and be able to see something that I can build and it make an impact on people's lives. And I feel like technology is one of the things that can really do that.
Nice. So how was your coding journey at Next?
It was difficult at first. Like, obviously, we have very little coding knowledge coming into the bootcamp, and the pace at which the bootcamp moves, you have to give 150% mm-hmm. of your effort, otherwise you're going to fall behind pretty quickly. For me personally, I put in a lot of effort at the weekends. I just literally coded nonstop for the whole 10 weeks. And there was sort of a turning point in the middle where things just started to click, and then from there it just came naturally.
How's your experience at Next, and what do you love the most?
It was really enjoyable, you know. You meet very like-minded people that mm-hmm. are really, you know, passionate about wanting to learn to code. So being surrounded by those kind of people and having great mentors that push you along the way really makes the experience enjoyable. And even if you get stuck, you know there's someone there that's going to give you that little nudge to get you back on your feet.
So what advice do you have for people who want to learn to code just like you, you know, to build things, like the things that you have done?
Yeah, obviously I would say don't sit around and wait things for it to happen. Take action, get yourself into a bootcamp, start learning to code as soon as possible, because obviously the amount of knowledge that you need to intake in such a short amount of time is quite considerable. Just work through as much coding material as you can. If you want to get involved with IoT devices, there's a lot of resources online that you can check out. And there's plenty of projects that people have already built with guides on how to do it as well. So yeah, there's great material out there that you can read and take on some projects for yourself. Hey guys, if you want to check out the app, feel free to go to the link below and you can view our web app through there.